Hi there. So let's go with the next topic, that is liquid crystal display. Basically, it is another type of display that we'll be seeing today. Why we go for liquid crystal displays? Basically, if you see with respect to the light emitting diodes or the normal OLEDs, Super AMOLEDs or LED displays, LCDs are more efficient in such a way that this liquid crystal displays needs very less power to turn it on or turn it off. We'll see that later on. But if you think about the light source or the backlight that I am speaking, that might take more power compared to that of AMOLEDs. So basically, if you just think about LCDs, LCD usually take low power. So it is not going to consider more power as that of LCDs. So to see a liquid crystal display, or however, how can I view a liquid crystal display, or how or what principle it works on, is basically you should be either having some sort of internal light source or external light source to view it. Okay, so the lifetime of this liquid crystal display is basically degradable because it is not as good as LEDs. Okay, when it comes for the lifetime or the operational time of an LCD, because LCD is made up of some sort of liquid within it, so that is a chemical component which degrades as time goes on. So basically, that is the only concern that we have while considering a liquid crystal display. So the next thing is, what is a liquid crystal, or how what it is made up of? Basically, the liquid crystal is a material which is, like, we normally call it as organic LCDs, which has properties like the liquid within it is going to flow like a liquid, or the material within it is going to flow like a liquid, wherein its molecular structure has some properties that is associated with solids. So what I am speaking, you will get to know in a meanwhile. So coming to this, there are three types of LCDs. One is reflective type of LCD. That means to say, you should be having an external light source to view that LCD or the display what is working, or you should be having an internal light source to view it, or there might be both together. We call it as transflective type liquid crystal displays, LCDs. Okay, so I'll try to give an example for transflective sometime later. So basically, the main component other than the LCD or the liquid crystal itself is a polarizer. Basically, without the polarizer, I can't have the operation of LCD properly. So basically, what is a polarizer going to do? I hope you all know that if you have an unpolarized light, the left part, whatever you are seeing is an unpolarized light, the vibration of the photon or the particle is in all direction. When it is passed through a polarizer, here it is a vertical polarizer, you only have the light component in vertical axis, or the motion of vibration is only available in the vertical component. Similarly, if I have a horizontal polarizer, which is horizontal in nature, I'll be only having the green component which you are seeing here. Okay, so that is about polarizer. So that is a main component of my LCD. Why? I'll let you know later. So when you see this, the in-between component is what is my liquid crystal display. This rod-like structure, what you are seeing here, is nothing but my pneumatic liquid crystal. Okay, and you can see a polarizer at the front or at the top and the bottom, and in between you are seeing electrodes. When I apply no potential, this rod-like structure will be aligned by its molecular nature, and the polarized light pass through this and it will be coming at the output side. Okay, when I apply a potential to this electrodes, and take for example, this is not a, whenever I speak about electrodes, you might think it is opaque, but these are not opaque, these are transparent electrodes. Okay, clear conductive electrodes. So this will pass light through it, and it is also conductive in nature. So when I apply potential, this structure gets disturbed and they get disoriented. So this light, whatever gets polarized, will now not pass through this. Okay, so to better understand this, consider this particular diagram which is there in your textbook and all. So this is a pneumatic liquid crystal structure with no applied potential. So basically you can see this clear conductive coating, and this is connected to the battery, or it is not connected to a battery now. So here it is not connected to a battery, and it is made up of indium oxide. Okay, when there is you can see the glass structure and some spacers and sealers. Within that I have my liquid, okay, or the crystal, liquid crystal, pneumatic liquid crystal. So when I have an incident light, the light simply passes through this particular pneumatic crystal, okay, without any obstruction. But now when I apply a potential, if you see that, when I apply a potential, what this potential does is, you can see the structure where the potential is not available, it is not disturbed. Whereas where the place I have applied a potential, the molecular structure is somewhat disturbed, and the light which was entering now gets diffracted, refracted, reflected within the structure itself, and it will not come out of the other end of my LCD. Okay, hence this region looks like frosted region. That means no light will be allowed out, or it looks like somewhat opaque. Okay, whereas in this clear region, light gets through and passes out. So this is a basic structure of a liquid crystal display, or basic operation of a liquid crystal display. Okay, so if you have seen this, obviously you have, you can see these digits, and this is actually made up of a liquid crystal display, and this is my transparent clear coated indium oxide material, where when I apply potential, the crystals beneath this will get disoriented like this, and it creates a frosted region wherein you can see there is no light coming out of this and it looks dark. Okay, that is the understanding. So this is called as a 7-segment or 8-segment display. Basically 8th segment is basically the decimal point. Here you have 7 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and the decimal point what you see is the 8th segment. So hence it is called as 8-segment digital display, or usually in your labs they'll be calling it as 7-segment displays. Okay, so I have already spoken about transmissive and reflective types of field effect transistors. So let us see what happens here. So when I have a transmissive field effect LCD, basically that means to say it should be having some sort of light within. An internal light source should be there. So you see here to the right, I have an internal light source, and this is incidented, and the structure is made up of, the actual thing is glass and sealers, and you have two things, a vertical light polarizer at the both the ends of my LCD. Okay, and the structure here is the molecular structure, or the rod like structure which we have already seen, is somewhat oriented like this. Means to say, when I have a vertically polarized light entering, as it flows through, or the light passes through that particular liquid crystal medium, it gets shifted 90 degrees or orthogonally towards horizontal polarization. Okay, since the outer polarizer is also a type of vertical light polarizer, the light will not get passed through. So if you want to show it here, you can see here it is some sort of horizontal polarized light flowing in. As this light flows through this medium, you can see there is a shift in this polarization, and at the outside you are seeing a vertical polarized light coming out. Similarly, what happens in my LCD also, as the light flows through, it gets a tilt in its polarization and it reaches the other end. So when I apply some potential, this polarization can be changed, or when I remove that potential, the polarization can be changed and you can get a light out of it. So to you or to us, this is how the structure looks like. So the internal light comes out when I take off the potential, or when I make it off. So if you want to make you understand much better, you can see the top one where we call it as a liquid crystal display is on. You can see the light enters at one end. So this is a rare vertical polarizer, only vertical component is coming, and this is my electrode segment, and as it passes through, it gets that shift which I was speaking, and since it comes out of this, at the viewer end you have another vertical polarizer, but since it is orthogonally tilted, now you are getting a horizontal polarized wave coming out of this, but this is a vertical polarizer, so it will not allow any component other than vertical polarized wave. So the viewer is viewing just a dark screen or complete black, you can think of. When I remove the when I say the liquid crystal is taken off, you can see the alignment of the rod like structure gets commonly aligned, and you see the vertical component getting vertically passed out, so it is always turn on, so there is no tilt in the light or the polarization of it. Okay, so you can see the light, or you can actually see the digits. So here whatever we are showing is when the liquid crystal is on, when the liquid crystal is off, that means you are seeing the internal light that is coming out of the structure. So this type of LEDs are LCDs are called as transmissive type LCDs. Okay, so this is one example, just to explain you how the light gets tilted. Okay, nothing else. This is how the light gets tilted from vertical polarized to horizontal polarized. Okay, the next type of LCDs are reflective type. So for reflective type, I already said I will be not using any internal light source. I can only have external light source, and with the help of external light source only I can operate it. You can see here it is also made up of the glass confined with some liquid crystal within it, and there are two polarizer here. One is vertical polarizer, that is at the input side, at the entry side, vertical polarizer. At the rear end you have a horizontal polarizer. Behind this you have something called as reflector. Reflector here means to say it might be a mirror, okay, which reflects back the light whatever it is being entered. So you can see as a incident light enters, since at the right side or the entry side I have a vertical light polarizer, I'll be only having vertical polarized component, and once it enters you have that orthogonal shift or 90 degree shift to that particular vertical polarized light, and it will be going back to this polarizer. Now this is a horizontal polarizer, and the component of light that is entering here is also horizontal, hence that light gets reflected back. Okay, when it gets reflected back, again you have a shift from 90 to 0 degree. Okay, so you mean to say the horizontal light will get back to be a vertical polarized light, and our eye or the viewer can view that light. Okay, so this is how this particular thing works, and you can see the clear conductive coating, where this coating is where the potential is applied in all the cases. So you can see like it is a symmetric device. Like light enters in this polarization, it shifts to the other polarized wave, and if I place a mirror here, the reflected wave will also have a reverse shift. So if from here it, if I call it as 0 to 90 degree, when it comes back from this point to this point, you can think of 90 back to 0 degree the reflected wave will be having. So that is the basic principle of this. So this is how it looks. So best example is your calculators. Whenever you see the dark portion is not the clear conducting surfaces will be having that potential turned on, hence this particular thing will be aligned to a vertical component. So I'll explain you here. You can see here light source and the viewer are both at the one end. You have only vertical polarized light coming in. This will be shifted to horizontal. Since the rear end is horizontal polarizer, it will hit the reflector and the reflected wave comes back. And again you have the same shift of 90 to 0 degree, and you have vertical light coming out and you are viewing that light as it is. But when I turn that particular liquid crystal display on, this pneumatic rod like structures whatever we have spoken will be aligned. Okay, when it is aligned, the light will be just the vertical polarized light, will not be having any shift at all. Okay, since the rod like structure are aligned, you don't have any shift, and the rear horizontal polarizer will now not allow any light to go through reflector. So since no light is passing through the reflector, no light comes out of this reflector also. Hence the viewer will not see any light that is coming out at this point. So he sees a dark patch. So that is what the dark patch that you see here. Okay, So, a short quiz for you. Before going to the quiz, this is how your calculator displays will be having. So, this is my liquid crystal structure or space where I have the pneumatic liquid crystal. This is the back side clear coating electrode. This is the front side 8 segment clear coated segment. And these are my polarizer. Okay. So, this is how I basically excite each and every electrode to turn on those particular pattern. Okay, now quiz time. Can you guess what is 1, what is 2, what is 3, the displays made up of? I'll give you 2 seconds, 10 seconds, okay, 20 seconds. Take a pen, take a paper, write what is 1, what is 2, what is 3. Pause the video for 10 seconds now. Let's see the answer. So basically, let's see what is the answer. The first one is reflective type. So if you have answered it as reflective type, great, good going. So what is the second one? Any guess? Okay, before going to the second one, tell me the third one. What is the third one? Actually, the second one is transreflective and the third one is transmissive. Internally, I'll be having a light source. Here, I can have a light source, or else I can also have an external light source. Both can be hold good here. So this is about LCDs. Hope you understood. If you have any issues, you can contact me or drop in your comments below. Thank you. Hi. So what you are saying here is reflective, transmissive, transreflective type of device. Okay, so see here closely, you have a mirror behind to reflect back the light, and you can actually see the transparent coating, the indium oxide coating, if you look closely. And whenever I apply a potential to those 7 segments, the light which is getting reflected back will be blocked, or you will be not having any reflections that is coming out of that source, hence the darker portions. Okay, so this is reflective type. This is transmissive type. Basically, this is a liquid crystal display which has RGB, so red, green, blue pixels. And if you see those, like if I vary the intensity, what is being varied? It is not the LCD's intensity is varied, it is the backlight's intensity is varied. So if I keep it to the maximum, then you have maximum intensity of the LCD. So if I keep it minimum, so you have minimum intensity of this particular LCD. So basically, this is a transmissive type wherein you should be having some sort of internal source to power it up. Coming to this part, okay, this is Amaze Fit BIP light, okay, wherein it is a transreflective. So if I turn this external source off and if I make it dark enough, okay, I have an internal light source which powers up the backlight and you can view the content of the screen or the liquid crystal display. Or if I turn on the external source, due to the reflection of my external light, you can also see the content. So this is transreflective type of LCDs that will be used within this. So this is a practical application of LCDs. Thank you.